لك رحمتك وعزائي مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر. ونسألك اللهم موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر. ونسألك اللهم الفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. هذان الحديثان ثابتان عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الشيخ بيغان حسين, اخوتي في الله, all my brothers in Allah, in this masjid that has tried to put forth that which it has of khair and that which it has and that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed of rahmah. And today we wish to go straight into the topic because of the shortness in time. The brothers, they have chosen the topic Sifatul Jannah, the description of Jannah and Paradise. He said, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes us from them, that He makes me from them, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes it easy for us to be from those who dwell in it. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes it easy for us to act those actions, na'am, that bring you closer to the Jannah, وَمَا يَقَرَّبُ إِلَيْهَا مِنْ قَوْلِنَا عَمَلٍ, that which will bring you closer to Allah, whether it is speech or actions. Na'am. And he mentioned that hadith, and also he mentioned a second hadith that Allahumma na'am, that you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestows upon us the mujibati rahmatik, na'am, that which necessitates His rahmah and His mercy. And the Shaykh, he mentions hadan al hadithan thabitan, these two hadiths and these two supplications are both affirmed and
إخوتي وأحبتي في الله, الجنة إذا أردنا أن نتحدث عنها فلعلنا نحصر الحديث في ثلاثة أمور. الأمر الأول الأسباب التي يجب أن نعنى بها استعدادا لدخول الجنة بعد رحمة الله عز وجل. والأمر الثاني أوصاف الجنة. والأمر الثالث وصايا خاصة للشباب.
The Sheikh, he mentioned, if we wish to speak about this topic of the description of paradise, then we could summarize our kalam into three parts. The first being the asbab and those ways and means of entering the paradise.
السبب الثاني صفة الجنة.
نعم. And the second being the description of paradise. And the third being wasaya khasa, specific advices that can be said for the shabab and the youth specifically.
الأمر الأول أعظم سبب لدخول الجنة هو تحقيق التوحيد وتصفيته من شوائب الشرك والبدع والمعاصي. فإذا حصل ذلك فهذا أعظم سبب لدخول الجنة ولو في المآل أو بعد وقت. فتحقيق التوحيد حتى ولو أن المسلم قد ابتلي بذنوب فإن نهايته دخول الجنة, والمسلم يحرص على تحقيق التوحيد ثم على الأسباب الأخرى التي سنذكرها إن شاء الله تبارك وتعالى. مقصود التوحيد تحقيقه تصفيته من شوائب الشرك والبدع والمعاصي وتخليصه, وأن نلقى الله بتوحيد خالص. ولا يكون التوحيد خالصا إلا إذا تحقق أمران. الأمر الأول إخلاص العمل لله وحده, والأمر الثاني الكفر بالطاغوت والبراءة من كل ما يعبد من دون الله.
The Shaykh, he went on by mentioning that the greatest reasons of entering paradise is that we establish the Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is from the greatest of means of entering into paradise, and that we stay far away from shirk and polytheism and worshipping others besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And other than that, and that is from the ways he mentions that this is from the greatest ways. If we do these two things, going closer towards the Jannah by التوحيد نعم and also staying away from shirk. ولو في المآل, even if this is at the end result of a person, نعم, even if it is that he is trialed with dhunub, he mentions, and sins, and he is one ابتلي بالذنوب, and he is considered one who has been trialed by committing sins, then eventually if his affair is that he enters the paradise, then this is the maqsood. And he says, so we stay away from the shawa'ib al-shirk, and that we stay away from all those things that may afflict a person, wherever it may be, of types of shirk and those things that lead to it. And he mentions that we have to وَلَا يَكُونُ حَاصِرًا, and this is not going to take place except that a person, he has ikhlas firstly, that he is sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and then it is also الْكُفْرُ بِالطَّاغُوتِ, that a person, he denounces anything that is worshipped besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
وَبِقَدْرِ ما يكون العبد المسلم محققا للتوحيد كلما ازداد تحقيقه للتوحيد كلما اضمحلت الذنوب وتلاشت وقلت وضعفت أمام التوحيد.
The Sheikh then said, and according to the person's level, and the abd and the slave, his level and that which he does of increasing that which he has of التوحيد and staying away from shirk, then there's no doubt, even if it is qalla wa da'uf, even if it is something that has lessened within him, and it is weak within him, then as for imam al-tawheed, and that which comes in front of tawheed, and that which he carries out of this tawheed, then this will aid that servant, and he is in accordance to that which the servant he does.
انظر يا عبد الله إلى حديث صاحب البطاقة, حاول أن تستوعبه جيدا. حديث صاحب البطاقة يؤتى برجل يوم القيامة, أنا أذكره لكم بالمعنى الذي يتضح. يؤتى برجل يوم القيامة فتنشر له 99 سجلا, يعني صحيفة قوية كبيرة, كل سجل منها مد البصر. مد البصر, الصحيفة الواحدة مد البصر 99 سجلا. فيقال له, أتنكر من هذا شيئا؟ قال لا يا رب, كلها ذنوب, يعني قد فعلتها. ثم يقال له, أظلمك الكتبة والحفظة؟ فيقول لا. ثم يقال له, أتذكر لك حسنة؟ فيقول لا أذكر شيئا. ثم يقال, بلى إن لك حسنة وإنك لن تظلم اليوم. ثم يؤتى ببطاقة كتبت عليها أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. فيبهت الرجل, يعني يحتار ويقول أين هذه البطاقة من تلك السجلات, 99 سجلة وهذه بطاقة صغيرة مكتوب عليها لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله. فيقال إنك لن تظلم. ثم توضع البطاقة في كفة, من كفة في الميزان يعني, وتوضع هذه السجلات في كفة فتطيش السجلات, يعني تخف, تصير خفيفة وتثقل البطاقة, تصبح هذه البطاقة ثقيلة, فيرجح الميزان بالبطاقة فيدخل الجنة. تأملوا هذا الحديث جيدا لأهمية تحقيق التوحيد.
He mentions, انظر يا عباد الله, look a servant of Allah towards the hadith of the bitaqa, that hadith, that person, he will come on the day of judgment with a specific card or like that which is similar to that. He mentions in this hadith, and I'll mention it by meaning, يُؤْتَى بِالرَّجُلِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, a man will be bought on the day of judgment. And he will be brought on this day, and there will be 99 scrolls on that day upon him. And every sigilla and every one of these scrolls is madd al-basar, it will reach that which the eye can see, as far as the eye can see. And it will be said to him, it will be said to this man, Atinkiru, do you deny that which is on this sigilla? Do you deny any of this? And he will say, no. أَظَلَمَكَ الْكَتَبَ وَالْحَفَظَةَ. Have you been oppressed by those who write down, those who have been ascribed to every person that he writes down? And he will mention, no.
هل تذكر لك حسنة؟
نعم هل تذكر لك حسنة؟ Do you remember any حسنة and good that has been done for you? And of course, بلا شك that he will remember this. Then he will be bought. Then all of this that he has done of sins will be on the scroll, and it will be brought a bidaqa, a card, or that which is similar to that, and it will be brought this card, and it will have on it ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. And he will said, where is this bidaqa from? What is it? And how will it come in accordance, and how will it way out when it comes to the different sigillat and scrolls compared to this one card that bears witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah? And it will be said to him, you will not be oppressed at all at this day. You will not be oppressed. So these sigillat and these scrolls, it will be placed upon a scale. And on the other side of the scale will be this bidaqa and this card bearing witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then this bidaqa, this card will outweigh that which he has, or that is upon the other side of the mizan and the other side of these scales of 99 scrolls. This one card and this one thing that he has of bearing witness that none has the right to be worshipped except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone will outweigh it. And for this he mentions, you should, O slave of Allah, you should reflect upon this much, na'am, that, and try to actualize this. Na'am. Try to actualize this tawheed.
فَانْظُرُوا يَا رَعَاكُمُ اللَّهِ إِلَىٰ أَيِّ مَدَىٰ يُضْعِفُ تَحْقِيقُ التَّوْحِيدِ الذُّنُوبِ وَيَمْحُوهَا وَيَقْضِي عَلَيْهَا.
He mentions, look, يَا رَعَاكَ اللَّهِ, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserve you, O slave of Allah, how and to the extent of that which this will aid you.
وَمِنَ الْأَسْبَابِ أَيْضًا مُضَاعَفَةُ الْأَعْمَالِ بما فيها الفرائض والنوافل. انظر إلى أول سورة المؤمنون, قد أفلح المؤمنون الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون والذين هم عن اللغو معرضون والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم ولفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم المفلحون فأولئك هم العادون. ثم قال والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون. يرثون ماذا؟ أولئك هم الوارثون الذين يرثون الفردوس ماذا؟ هم فيها خالدون. فأنا سأختصر الأسباب نظرا لضيق الوقت وركز على هذه الأسباب العظيمة في أول سورة المؤمنون, وسأذكر بعدها حديثا في الأسباب ثم ننتقل إلى صفة الجنة.
And he mentions that from the أسباب مضاعفة أعمال الصالحة, that the righteous actions being one, when a person's plentiful in it, it will be and multiply for him its reward. He said if we were just to look at Surah Al-Mu'minun, we will find in this surah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the believers, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that successful are the believers, الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, those who are humble and submissive in their prayer, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, and those who turn away from false speech. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ and those who pay their zakat. وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ and those who preserve and guard their chastity in their private parts. إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِمْ except when it comes to their own wives. أَوْ مَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُهُمْ or that which their right hand possesses. فَإِنَّهُمْ غَيْرُ مُلُومِينَ in this they are ones who are free from blame. فَمَنِ ابْتَغَى وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْعَادُونَ whoever desires more than this or beyond this, then those are those who are transgressful. And they are the transgressors. The Shaykh, he mentioned up until where he mentions, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَلَىٰ صَلَوَاتِهِمْ يُحَافِظُونَ and those who again, they preserve their prayers. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ those are the inheritors. الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ they are the ones who will inherit the Firdaus paradise, هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ where they will dwell therein forever. نعم.
أما الحديث فهو حديث قدسي وقد جاء في آخره ولا وما تقرب عبدي إلي بشيء أحب إلي مما افترضته عليه أحب شيء إلى الله هو التقرب إليه بالفرائض ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه النوافل التطوعات سواء في الصلاة أو في الصوم أو في الصدقات أو نحو ذلك حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته إذا أحبه الله دخل الجنة كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به أي أسدده ووفقه في سمعه وبصره الذي يبصر به أسدده في بصره فلا ينظر إلى محرم ورجله التي يمشي بها أسدده في مشيه وأوفقه فلا يمشي بها إلا فيما أحل الله ويده التي يبطش بها لا أسدده في مد يده فلا يمدها إلى محرم ولا يبطش بها محرما ثم وضح دليل ذلك بقوله ولئن سألني لأعطينه إذا كان بهذه المثابة يعبد الله حق عبادته يؤدي الفرائض والنوافل فإنه يكسب محبة الله عز وجل فإذا سأل الله أعطاه ولئن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنه إذا لجأ إلى الله ولاذ به واستعاذ به واعتصم به فإن الله عز وجل يعيذه ويحفظه ويكلأه حتى يدخل الجنة. نعم.
He said, as for the hadith, then we'll look at a hadith that is Qudsi, that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated from his Lord. And it is the hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْهِ مِثْمَ افْتَرَبْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ And the servant, he doesn't get closer to his Lord. My servant, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying this in this hadith of Qudsi, that my servant, he doesn't get closer to me except in that which, or first and foremost, in that which, مِدْمَا افْتَرَبْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ, in that which I have made obligatory upon him. وَلَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهِ And the servant, he doesn't continue to be upon this and continue to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the recommended acts until I love him. فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتَهُ كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ And if I love him, then and when I love him, he will be, it will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it that كُنْتُ سَمْعَهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ I will be that hearing that he is with. وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ And that sight that he sees with. وَيَدَهُ الَّذِي يُبْطِشُ بِهَا And that hand that he stretches forth with. وَرِجْلَهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا And those, the feet that he walks with. And the Shaykh
مثل هذا لا يفسر حرفيا يفسر بمدلوله الشرعي يعني كنت سمعه سددته بسمعه أسدده بسمعه أسدده في بصره أسدده في مشيه أسدده في بطشه
طيب نعم so within the كلام while the Shaykh was reading this hadith earlier he mentioned that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the person tawfiq in carrying this out. He will give him tawfiq in when na'am kuntu sam'ahu alladhi yasma'u bih. He will usaddiduhu, the Sheikh mentions that he will make it easy for him and give him this tawfiq and the success in being that he will make it hear, na'am, him hear that which is good. وَبَصَرَهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ na'am. And he will make it that he would not look at except that which is good. فَلَا يَنظُرُ إِلَى مُحَرَّمُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him the tawfiq and the success that he will not look at any muharram, anything that is impermissible. And he also mentioned وَيَدَهُ الَّذِي يُبْتِشُ بِهَا. And that now that hand that he stretches forth with, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again will give him the tawfiq only to go forth in that which and stretch out forth for that which is good. Na'am.
رجله الذي يمشي بها.
And that feet that he walks with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it only that he will walk towards those things that have khayr in it for him. And then the Shaykh mentions, until it is mentioned in this statement, in this hadith, it mentioned, وَإِن سَأَلَنِي لَأُعْطِيَنَّ. And if he asks of me, the result of this he mentions is, if he asks of me, I will give him. وَإِن اسْتَعَاذَنِي لَأُعِيذَنَّ. And if he seeks refuge in me, I will give him that refuge.
بعد هذا إخوتي وأحبتي فينا ننتقل إلى بعض صفات الجنة الواردة في القرآن والسنة. أولا في الجنة ما لا عين كما أخبر الصادق المصدوق صلى الله عليه وسلم فيما يروي عن ربه جل وعلا أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر لم يسمع به. فيها ما لا يتصور, لم تسمع بتسمع بالأسماء لكن الحقيقة غير, وكذلك ما لا يتصور في البصر, وكذلك لا يخطر ببال أحد ولا بقلب أحد. ولذلك يقول الله جل وعلا, يقول الله فلا تعلم نفس ما أخفي لهم من قرة أعين جزاء بما كانوا يعملون.
He mentions after this, the Sheikh, after this, we will mention and talk about the descriptions of this paradise. And in this Jannah, he mentions, and in this paradise, it has that which no one has heard of, or no one has seen. أَعْدَدْتُ لِعِبَادِيَ الصَّالِحِينَ. I have prepared for my righteous slaves, مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَأَتْ, that which no eye has seen. وَلَا أُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ, and no ear has heard. وَلَا خَطَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرٍ, and it has not come upon any heart and anyone to comprehend and actually see it or come about that he knows of it completely. He mentions in this paradise there are things that you have never heard before, and it has never come to you its sound. And also there are that which you have never seen, and it has not come to you how it could have looked like. Also there is nothing in this paradise that has befallen the heart of a person and he can actually comprehend and actually know its clear status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that knowledge. فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. He mentions, فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this verse that no one knows that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has kept there, na'am, and kept with him, مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنْ, that which brings pleasure to our eyes, as a reward for that which they used to do.
وفي سورة محمد يقول الله عز وجل في وصف الجنة مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون, يعني التي وعد الله عباده المتقين, فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن, ماء صافي ليس فيه كدر ليس فيه تعكر, وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه, ما في غشاشين يغشون اللبن كما هو الحال عند الناس هنا, لبن لم يتغير طعمه كما حلب من أمه, لكنه لا يدرى من لا نعلم من أين وإن نؤمن بأن الله يأتي به ويجعله نهرا, وأنهار من خمر اللذة للشاربين، ومن شرب خمر الدنيا حرم عليه خمر الآخرة. من شرب خمر الدنيا حرم عليه خمر الآخرة. وخمر الآخرة عظيم، يطاف عليهم بكأس من معين، ويقال تعالى يتنازعون فيها كأسا لا لغو فيها ولا تأثيم، إلى غير ذلك من أوصاف خمر الآخرة. وأنهار من عسل مصفى، ما فيه شمع ولا قطع نحل ولا بقايا من النحل، من عسل مصفى، شهد هني نظيف جدا، ها صافي مصفى. ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات، بعد هذا، بعد هذه الأنهار الأربعة، ولهم فيها من كل الثمرات كما تقدمت الآية، وفيها ما تشتهي الأنفس وتلذ الأعين وهم فيها خالدون. تفضل
الشيخ. After this he said, if we were to look after in Surah Muhammad, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, مثل الجنة التي وعد المتقون, that paradise that has been promised for the those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فيها أنهار من ماء غير آسن. In it is anhar and rivers of water that are not stagnant and that have not changed in its state. وأنهار من لبن لم يتغير طعمه. And there are rivers that are of milk. لم يتغير طعمه. Its milk and its taste hasn't gone off and changed again. It hasn't changed and expired. And he says, it's not like in this dunya where we have Ash-Shashir and those who have changed about the state of this milk, maybe added things to it. It's not that case. As for the hereafter, then it is كما حلم من أمه, as if it has come out of your mother. That fresh, he mentioned. He mentions after this, وأنهار من خمر لذة للشاربين. And then there is أنهار, again rivers of خمر. And this خمر is لذة للشاربين. It is delicious and one that is sweet for those who drink from it. And he mentions, ومن شرب الخمر في الدنيا, and whoever drinks that which you find of khamar in this dunya, alcohol that is in this dunya, whoever drinks this, then he is prevented from drinking from that of the khamar that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made in the hereafter in paradise. وَأَنْهَارٌ مِنْ عَسَلٍ مُصَفَّى. And then there are rivers of honey that are clarified and pure in this, in its state. Naam, there is this honey, and the Shaykh himself mentioned honey. No need to translate that word exactly, because he himself, mashallah, translated and knows of that. There will be honey that is pure. وَلَهُمْ فِيهَا مِنْ كُلِّ الثَّمَرَاتِ. And up beyond that, and to exceed upon that, there is in it every type of fruit. وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. And forgiveness from your Lord. Naam. So the Shaykh, he mentions that that is that which you find in the hereafter, and they will dwell therein forever.
من أوصاف الجنة ما جاء في سورة الحاقة. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فهو في عيشة راضية في جنة عالية, جنة عظيمة عالية القدر والمكان, قطوفها دانية, ما تحتاج تأتي وتقصها بالسكين, هي تأتيك تتدلى إليك, قطوف الجنة وعناقيدها تتدلى إليك بدون كلفة, قطوفها دانية, كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما أسلفتم في الأيام الخالية, أي بسبب أعمالكم, هي برحمة الله لكن بسبب أعمالكم الصالحة التي عملتموها في الدنيا.
After this, the Shaykh, he spoke of that which is prepared for the believers on the Day of Judgment. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ. And then, as for the one who his book is brought and given to him in his right hand, فَيَقُولُ هَا مُقْرَأُ كِتَابِيَهِ. Look at that which
the,
in his book, that which book that he has taken from his right hand. إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابية. I knew that I would meet my Lord. فهو في عيشة راضية.
ظننت will... هنا بمعنى أيقنت. ظننت وليس الظن يعني المترجح، لا أيقنت. نعم.
نعم. So here the Sheikh, he mentions that the meaning of this ظننت is not that I thought that I would meet the my Lord and my حساب and that of my reckoning, but it means that I knew, as was translated, I knew that I would meet my Lord and that in the حساب of my Lord. فهو في عيشة راضية. So he will be in a happy state at that moment. في جنة عالية, in a paradise that is high and lofty. So the Sheikh, he mentions, نعم, that is the awsaf of Jannah and the description of Jannah, that is a state is lofty and is high. قطوفها دانية, it is, its fruits are close by. نعم. قطوفها دانية, its fruits are close by for the person. I mean, the Sheikh mentions here, لا يحتاج بالسكين, he doesn't require a knife, he doesn't require anything of that to cut from that. And he mentions, بدون كلفة, it will reach the person without any struggle and any difficulty. And he mentions, this is بسبب أعمالكم, this is because of that which you used to do and your actions. That which you used to do, he mentions, in the dunya.
والحقيقة الأوصاف كثيرة والوقت يقرب, لكن لعلي أختم الكلمة بوصايا معينة لإخوتي عليهم أن يتنبهوا لها. فأول تلك الوصايا تقوى الله تبارك وتعالى بفعل أوامره واجتناب نواهيه والعمل بما يرضيه. نعم.
He mentions and the descriptions of this paradise are in fact very much and cannot be mentioned in this small gathering and time that we have. So I wish to finish with a few words for our brothers as an advice. And the first of them, of these advices, is the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Taqwa al-imtithal awamir wa ijtinab an-nawahi.
Na'am. That we do carry out this taqwa by fulfilling all of the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us to carry out and staying away from everything that He has forbade us from.
Wa taqwa hiya wasiyatullah lil awwalin wal akhirin. Qala ta'ala, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ أَنِ اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ أي قوموا بامتثال الأوامر واجتناب النواهي.
He mentions that the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the wasiyah, and that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala admonished and advised His creation في الأولين والآخرين, those that were the foremost in the beginning of them, and the akhirin, and those that will come. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَلَقَدْ وَصَّيْنَا الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابِ, and we have admonished and advised those who were given the book, مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَإِيَّاكُمْ, from those who were before you and yourselves, أَنْ اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ, that you fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is that you come about with everything of the awamir that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered you to do, وَاجْتِنَابُ النَّوَاهِي, and staying away from all the forbidden acts that he has told you to stay away from.
سُئِلَ التَّابِعِيُّ الْجَلِيلُ عبد سُئِلَ التَّابِعِيُّ الْجَلِيلُ طَلْقُ بْنُ حَبِيبٍ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْ مَعْنَى التَّقْوَى فَقَالَ وَبَيَّنَ بَعْدَ أَنْ بَيَّنَ أَنَّهَا هِيَ الْمَخْرَجُ مِنَ الْفِتَنِ قَالَ بَعْدَ أَنْ بَيَّنَ أَنَّهَا هِيَ الْمَخْرَجُ مِنَ الْفِتَنِ إِذَا كَثُرَتْ قَالَ التَّقْوَى أَنْ تَعْمَلَ بِطَاعَةِ اللَّهِ على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله وأن تترك ما حرم الله وأن تترك ما حرم الله على نور من الله تخاف عقاب الله. وفي هذا المعنى يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله فرض فرائض فلا تضيعوها. إن الله فرض فرائض فلا تضيعوها وحد حدودا فلا تعتدوها أي لا تتجاوزوا ما حد الله لكم وحرم أشياء فلا تنتهكوها، لا تنتهكوا حرمات الله، ابتعدوا عن المحرمات. وسكت عن أشياء رحمة بكم غير نسيان، وسكت عن أشياء رحمة بكم غير نسيان فلا تسألوا عنها.
He mentions it was asked to the Tabi'i al-Jalil, that beloved Tabi'i, Talq ibn Habib, regarding this taqwa. He spoke about this, and after he spoke about that it being a makhraj min al-fitan, a way to escape the different trials and tribulations upon the person, he mentioned its definition and explained what it is, this taqwa. أن تعمل على نور من الله. That you act out these actions على نور من الله.
أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله.
أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله. That you carry out these. نعم. You carry out these righteous actions upon a light from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Upon a light from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. For the reward of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And it is what, and also it compromises what, أن تترك ما حرم الله. And that you leave off that which Allah سبحانه وتعالى has forbidden. على نور من الله. Again, with light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, تخاف عقاب الله, fearing the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also within this meaning, you find that which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself mentioned. إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَرَضَ فَرَائِضَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made about many obligations. فَلَا تُضَيِّعُوهَا. So do not be one who comes about now and does not fulfill this and doesn't carry this out. وَحَدَّدَ حُدُودًا. And he also made about hudud and boundaries that you should not go beyond. So do not go beyond them. وَحَرَّمَ أَشْيَاءً. And he has also forbidden for you ashya and many things. فَلَا تَنْتَهِيكُهَا. And so do not come and carry them out and commit them. وَسَكَتَ عَنْ أَشْيَاءَ. And he has kept quiet about some things. نعم, there are things that he has kept about quiet, so do not ask about them and delve into them.
كما أوصي الإخوة بعدة وصايا ألخصها في نقاط سريعة. أولا, الجد والاجتهاد في العلم والتعلم والتفقه في دين الله. ثانيا, الاجتهاد في تحقيق التوحيد وتصفيته من شوائب الشرك والبدع والمعاصي. وثالثا, الاجتهاد في طلب العلم على أيدي العلماء الربانيين الذين ينفون عن كتاب الله تعالى تحريف الغالين وانتحال المبطلين وتأويل الجاهلين. من ذلك أيضا التخلق بالأخلاق الفاضلة مع إخوانكم وحتى مع من تدعونهم من أهل هذا البلد, من تدعونهم إلى الإسلام, تتخلقون معهم بالأخلاق الفاضلة مع الثبات على الدين وعدم التنازل عن شيء منه. ومن ذلك أيضا التراحم والتآلف والجد والاجتهاد في التحاب في الله عز وجل والبعد عن أسباب الخلاف والتقاطع والتهاجر الذي يسلكه بعض الناس الذين تركوا العلم والتعلم واشتغلوا بالتقاطع والتهاجر بدون أسباب يمكن أن يعول عليها. عدم التسرع في قبول الأخبار, يعني التريث والتثبت, كما قال الله تعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا أن تصيبوا قوما بجهالة فتصبحوا على ما فعلتم نادمين. من ذلك أيضا الترفق والرفق في الدعوة إلى الله عز وجل حتى مع المخالفين, من أجل أن لأن الهدف هو هداية الناس إلى الخير. لأن يهدي الله بك رجلا واحدا خير لك من حمر النعم. ومن ذلك أيضا المحافظة على الوقت. يا عبد الله, يقول الوقت كالسيف, الوقت أعظم من السيف. يقول الوقت من ذهب, الوقت أغلى من الذهب. لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع، عن شبابه فيما أبلاه، وعن عمره فيما أثناه، وعن ماله من أين اكتسبه وأين أنفقه، وعن علمه ماذا عمل به. وهناك في الحقيقة وصايا أخرى، لكني أرى صلاة المغرب قد أزفت. والله نسأل لنا ولكم التوفيق والسداد، وأن كما جمعنا في هذا البيت بيوت الله أن يجمعنا وإياكم في الجنة. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه.
After this, the Sheikh, he mentioned there are a few other advices that I would like to spread and speak of. أولا, he mentions الجد والاجتهاد, that a person, he must strive and go forth and have much enthusiasm when it comes to this knowledge. And second, he mentions that a person, he again goes forth when it comes to the tawheed and works hard in actualizing this and bringing it about in his life and staying away from every type of shirk. And then he mentions the third is al-ijtihad. Again, the person, he strives in this ilm, fi yadi al-ulama al-rabbaniyin, and when it comes to with the scholars, those well-grounded scholars, that he spends time with them. For they are those who come about and teach the people and rid them from the ta'wil and the different interpretations of others. Na'am. And then he mentions a fourth. The person who comes with تخلق بأخلاق الفاضلة, that a person who comes about with great and lofty mannerisms, he incorporates this into his life. And that even this, he says, is that you call others, even the disbelievers, the kuffar, you call them to this that which you are upon. And you be careful of tanazu and those things that are differing that may cause between you. He mentions the fifth, التراحم والتحابب, that you increase within yourselves that this love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, and you increase this tarahum and mercy from one to another. Na'am. And you be wary of asbabul khilaf and those things that will cause about differing. Na'am. And those who will bring this about, those who are busy with this, he mentions, biduni asbab, they don't have any reason really to come about with this, and they haven't come about with its reasoning. Then don't busy yourself with that. And adam al-qubul al-akhbar, that you don't take everything that you hear, بدون التثبت, and not looking into that which a person has come about with. A person must be one who he looks at what he's heard and what he comes with. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَا يُلَذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا. All you who believe, if a fasiq, a sinful person, he comes and informs you of the news, فَتَبَيَّنُوا, then let him make تَبَيَّنَ تَثَبُّتَ, and realize and go back to and clarify what this person he has said, and verify this news. أَن تُصِيبُوا قَوْمًا بِجَهَالَةٍ فَتُصْبِحُوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلْتُمْ نَادِمِينَ, lest you harm a people in ignorance after you have become regretful of what you have done. That may come about regret from that which you have done. And so the Shaykh, he mentions that you are ones who are diligent in this. وَالتَّرَفُّقُ, and that you have this rift between yourselves. Everyone should have rift with his brother and gentleness with his brother. And this is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even said, لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمِرِ النِّعَمِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides by way of you one man, one person, it is better for you than the red camels. And then he mentions that we must look after al-muhafaza ala al-waqt, let us preserve our times, our brothers. He mentions, for it is said that that things are expensive and wealthy, and wealth has wealth with it. He mentions al-waqtu aghla, rather time is one that is more beloved to us and worth more in value, and it is worth more than that dhahab. Then after this, the Shaykh, he mentioned the hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, la tazulu qadama 'abdin yawm al-qiyamah hatta yus'al an 'umrihi fima afnah. He mentioned that the servant's feet will not move on the day of judgment until he is asked about an umrihi, his lifespan. Fima afna, what has he spent and how has he lived his life? Wa an ilmihi, fima fa'al, and that of his ilm and knowledge, what did he do with it and how did he act with it? Wa an malihi, and his wealth, min ayna iktasaba huwa fima anfaqa, and his wealth, how did he earn it, and then how did afterward did he go and spend it forth? Wa an jismihi fima abla, and also his body, and that which Allah has given him of strength, How did he go about now and carry this out? So he mentions the Shaykh, the time of Maghrib has come upon us, Ikhwani fillah. These are something that we have mentioned regarding the paradise. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept this from the Shaykh. And we thank the brothers for their patience in waiting in the beginning of the lecture. Jazakumullahu khairan. Walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Allahi rabbil alameen. Allahi rabbil alameen. Allahi rabbil alameen. Allahi rabbil alameen.